in this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint the Askurgan Curseblood, so they can hunt and destroy the beasts of the Gnarlwoods. The first thing we've done is undercoated our model, and for this colour scheme, we've used Grey Sear. This will give us a great base coat for the contrast paints we'll be using today. It's also a good idea to have the base paint that matches the spray to hand, to tidy up any mistakes. The 10 paints you'll need are on the screen right now. Remember that these are our recommendations, so feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you're new to painting or want to know the paints and the techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. First, we'll apply Rakarth Flesh to the skin with our small base brush. As we're applying it over Grey Sear, which is a light undercoat, we'll only be needing one thin layer to cover. There are parts of the skin we'll be making darker soon, but by covering all of the skin in the same base paint gives us a uniform finish when the rest of the skin is complete. If we get any of the paint into the wounds, just wait for the paint to dry and then apply a small amount of Grey Sear to tidy those up. Rakarth Flesh is a great colour for the pallid skin of the undead, but you can pick any colours you want for the rest of your warband. Next, we're using Dryad Bark for the skin found on the arms, feet, back and hair roots. Don't worry about the hands, as we'll be painting them in another colour later, so just paint up to the wrists. Also paint from the feet up to the top of the calves, just stopping below the knees. As we're painting our Curseblood quickly, we'll be using an efficient technique that makes the colours look like fur. We'll use the tip of the brush to create jagged markings that meet the Rakarth Flesh. You can make them as small or as big as you want. On ours here, we're making them small so they look more like little hairs blending into the skin. Now that we're happy with the darker skin tone, we can paint the hands with Doomball Brown. We'll be using the same technique as before, applying it with small brush strokes to blend in the paint to the darker skin, just above the wrists. We may need a couple of layers for good coverage over the hands, but we'll use less when it comes to covering the Dryad Bark wrists. This will make the blend between the two a lot softer. Doomball Brown is the perfect colour for the lighter, blood-soaked skin of this beast-like Askurgan. After all our skin tones are applied, remember to tidy up the cloth, the belt, and the wounds with Grey Sear if needed, so they're ready for our next colours. Next, we'll be using Griffhound Orange for the cloth and hair tips. We'll get a good amount on our small base brush for larger areas like the cloth, and for smaller areas we'll use our small layer brush to get into those hard to reach places. If we get any on the skin or the rope, don't worry, this is easily fixed and can be tidied up really easily by following the steps previously used after the contrast is dry. We can also add another thin layer of Griffhound Orange if you find it's too light on those raised areas and you want it a little bit darker. After the orange is dry, we'll apply Flesh Tearer's Red to the wounds on the skin and on the tongue. We'll use our small layer brush for these small details. If we get any on the skin, don't worry, we'll just follow the steps we used to tidy up the Griffhound Orange before. When the tongue is dry, now is the best time to paint the fangs and teeth in with Grey Sear to tidy them up before our next colours. Now we'll use Iron Warriors for the tacit armour and bracelet. With our small layer brush, we'll get into those hard to reach places and avoid anything that is already painted or still needs to be Grey Sear, like the ropes. I'm happy with the coverage I have here, but if you need to, you can add another layer to make sure yours has full coverage. Iron Warriors is perfect for the dark, strong metal that the Askurgans use for their warrior arts of battle against the beasts of Gur. After we've finished with Iron Warriors, it's time to change our paint water, so we don't get any metallic flakes into the rest of our colours. With our water changed, now we can thin down some Black Legion for applying over the Iron Warriors. We'll be using 2 parts water to 1 part Black Legion, as we want the mix to cover like a heavy shade. After applying it to the metal, we drop a small amount into the eye sockets. This means that the eyes will stand out later when we paint them last. Then for the claws, we'll be using Black Legion straight out the pot. Black Legion is a very heavy black contrast, but by thinning it down with various amounts of water, we can get different shades that we can use in many different ways, from armour to eye sockets. Next, we'll use Agrax Earthshade. Agrax Earthshade is a versatile paint and we'll be using it for 2 purposes. We'll use it straight out of the pot for the rope and the recesses of the orange cloth, as they are filthy from roaming the Gnarlwood. Then we'll use 2 parts water to 1 part Agraxer shade for a lighter shade. We'll use this all over the skin colours to tie them all together. Be careful that we don't overlay the lighter areas of the skin though. You can be heavier on the darker areas and pop some into the hair roots as well. If you do get too much on the skin, you can either remove it with a damp clean brush or leave it to dry, then apply Rakkar Flesh over the raised areas to lighten it back up. With everything fully dried, we can do a light dry brush of Screaming Skull over the cloth, hair and skin. We'll be focusing on those raised areas and edges by dry brushing in certain directions. This will catch those edges, avoiding being too heavy on flat areas of skin. Dry brushing can add that extra level of detail whilst being quick and effective when done on raised areas. Just remember to keep a small amount of paint on the brush to avoid a dusty finish, but not too much as we don't want to streak paint over the model. You can always check out a dry brushing video to learn more if you're new to this technique. Now that our model is painted, we can add that little extra detail if you feel confident for that extra bite of colour. For that little bit of spookiness, we'll be adding Fire Dragon Bright for some glowing eyes. We'll add a small dot of paint over the shaded eye socket with our small layer brush. We'll be using the tip of the brush to gently add small amounts of paint to the area. It's best to do this in small light layers as we want to keep the effect subtle. You can have any colour eyes you wish. We picked Fire Dragon Bright as we've already got orange in the colour scheme, so they will tie in with the rest of the model, and it won't add too many different colours to our pallid undead warband. And there we are! Your Askurgan Curseblood is finished and terrifying to behold. You can see that our model is based in Sterling Battlemire, but you can base it in any colour you want. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video all about it. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye!